Hello there, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Keith Rainz. So in this video I'm going to talk about the reasons why I left Forex trading. But before I go on, if you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe for awesome content and also click the like button if you get to like the video. If you're not, simply you can click the like or dislike button at the end of the video and tell me the reason why you did not get to like the video. So without wasting much of your time, I've written down everything I would like to share with you so that I don't end up keeping quiet and thinking what to talk about. Okay, so first of all, before I say the reasons why I left Forex trading, let me go back to the beginning. When did I start Forex trading? As far as I can remember, I started Forex trading in 2018. Okay, I started a platform called IQ Option. I'm sure that's the platform everyone starts with. Okay, so one might be asking, why did I start Forex trading? Okay, everyone, I'm sure the reason why people start Forex trading is because they want to make money, you can make money online, they don't need much capital, you can start with $10, blah, 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 and so on. Okay, and I'm one of them. I started Forex trading so that I can be able to make money online on my phone or on my laptop the easy way. Okay, so was Forex trading my first year profitable? Nope. Forex trading for me, it wasn't profitable in the first year. Okay, I myself taught. I taught myself. I learned from my own mistakes. I learned from anywhere. I learned some strategies on YouTube, Google, and so on. Most of the things I know, I used to search on my own. Okay, so as for me, I learned it the hard way. So in my first year of Forex trading, it wasn't so profitable. So when we came into 2019, at least I started gaining up some experience and it became better and better and better and better. So from there, I left Forex trading, but I did not completely leave Forex trading. I went to what's called Volatility Indices. I'm sure everyone is trading this. Yeah, there are people post signals about this, also make videos about this. There's boom 1000, crash 1000, V75 and so on. So why did I switch from Forex to Volatility Indices? So before I go on to what Volatility Indices, okay, there's a difference. Okay, Forex trading is a trading, or like, okay, it's the buying and selling of currencies. For example, buy dollar, you sell these other currencies and so on. But when it comes to Volatility Indices, these are not currencies. Okay, they are very volatile, and with Volatility Indices you can make money fast and you can also make losses fast. Okay, so with Volatility Indices it's possible to make $1,000 in a day, and it's also possible to lose $1,000,000 in a day. Okay, so are Volatility Indices profitable? Yes, they are very much profitable. I was able to make something out of them than Forex trading. Okay, so might be asking, how much was I making with the Volatility Indices? Okay, first of all, by that time when I started Forex trading, I was actually a student, and I'm not like on a monthly payment whereby I'm depositing this amount and this amount. Okay, so when I started Forex trading, I actually deposited my $10, $15. You trade, make a $20 or a $30, you withdraw, you forget, again you do that and that. Okay, now when I came to Volatility Indices, it was whereby if I deposited $10, there's the point where I would reach $100 profit out of a $10. Then again, suddenly from there, I end up, I was like, if I make $100 from a $10, maybe the following day, I'll lose it all, like lose all the money. Okay, so this is where it comes to the reason why I left Forex and Volatility Indices, or just completely left them. Okay, so here are the reasons why I left Forex trading and Volatility Indices. Okay, so but before I explain the reasons why I left these things, I'm not here to discourage you. Okay, these things, they're very much profitable, just need to then practice, and yeah, just practice and then as much as you can. Don't depend on external signals and so on. Learn to make your own. So now let's get started. The reasons why I left Forex trading and Volatility Indices. Okay, so the first reason is that The first reason why I left these things is because these things are time consuming, okay? With Forex trading and volatility indices, I used to spend like an entire day just in front of my laptop, and I had no time to do other things which might help me, like hang out with friends, do other things and so on. So it was time consuming and I didn't really enjoy much of my time doing other things. So this is the reason why I left these things. The second reason is that profits were not guaranteed, okay? No matter how good you are at Forex trading, if you're an expert, but losses will still be there. So in Forex trading, it's all about making more profits than making losses. So if you're able to make more profits than losses, then you're okay, you can continue trading, okay? Yeah. As for me, it's not like maybe I wasn't making more profits than making losses. Okay, actually, I was sometimes making profits more than losses, sometimes make losses more than profits. It's normal for that, okay? So just don't need to give up. But I have my own reasons why I gave up on Forex trading. So let's go on to the third reason why I left Forex trading and volatility indices. Okay, so the third reason why I left these things is because these things, they are very stressful. Okay, yeah, they are very stressful. If I'm not that type of person whereby if you lose money, okay, it's like this, like in Forex trading, like there are times you buy, may deposit all your money and you lose it all. And what happens, for example, if you're depositing a $500 and you lose the $500 within an hour, what will happen to you? Yeah, I'm sure you will not be happy, your mood will be destroyed, you'll be mentally disturbed, like you'll be just different, like you'll be just stressful. Okay, so this Forex trading is very stressful. And there are sometimes whereby you can lose all the money. Sometimes you can win as much as possible. Yeah. So in Forex trading, there are happy days and sad days. Yeah. So this is one of the reasons why I left these things. The other reason that I've written down is that it's too addictive. Okay. Yeah. So Forex just as another business. No. Forex just as football betting. They're more like the same. They're kind of similar. These things, they are very addictive because you might deposit $10. You make $100. What will happen from that? You'll be like, oh, wow, I made $100 from a $10. Then I think I'll continue trading more and make more. So this is it. So we end up becoming greedy whereby you'll be depositing my $10, thinking of making more money, and in the process you're becoming addicted to that. So that's a bad thing for you. Yeah. Okay, so let's go with the fifth reason. Okay, I have a personal goal. I'm sure everyone does have personal goals. Okay, so my fifth reason or my last reason why I left this thing is because they did not meet my goal. So what is my goal? Okay, my goal is to become financially stable or become successful. So by this, I don't mean that I need to own Lamborghinis and so on, expensive cars, clothes, houses and so on. No. Me, successful, I define it as being able to make money even when you're sleeping and being able to meet your daily needs. For example, if I've got a house, you're able to meet monthly renting fees, you're able to provide food, you're able to provide for your own clothes. Okay, this is what I call successful. Okay, so not successful, I don't mean maybe having expensive things like cars, okay, but you might need just a car for your daily activities, okay. So that's what I call successful for me. So my goal is to become successful in everything. So Forex trading did not help me with that because there are times whereby if you don't trade, you will not have money. So for you to have money, you have to trade. So there's no way you can make money while you're sleeping unless you're using a robot. Okay, so robots or bots, okay, I'll make a video on that one. These things, they're not reliable. Okay, they can work today, tomorrow they might not work. So I can't rely on them to help me build my future. Okay, so that's the reason why I left these things. Me, my goal is to be able to make money even when I'm sleeping and do other things and invest in other things. So these are the reasons I had for you today. Okay, so I also promised that I'll talk about what I'm doing since I've left Forex trading. So what am I doing right now? Okay, I have a lot of projects I'm building up, of which some of them I can't really mention as of now because this is when I'm starting out. But as of now, I'm currently having a website. I'm sure you've seen my website is kathrains.me. I'll put a link in the description below. Okay, so on my website, I've got what we call AdSense, Google AdSense enabled. Okay, this is where AdSense is a platform by Google where you sign up if you've got a website, and they'll give you a code where you have to put a code on the website. And on the website, when visitors visit the website, they'll be seeing some adverts. So what happens is this: when people click on your ads on your website, you earn money, or when they view the adverts on your website. Okay, so there are two ways in which Google pays if you have a website. Okay, it pays per click. There's what they call cost per click. How much does it cost when someone clicks an advert, and how much does Google pay you when 1,000 of people see your ad? Okay, so this is a different topic of which I might talk about later on, but this video is strictly about the reasons why I left Forex trading. So in future, if you'd like me to make a video on how much Google pays me on my website, simply like this video, comment below, and I might make a video even tomorrow or even today if possible. Okay, so I also have other business ideas of which I'll share with you later on. I'm currently working on, as of now, I'm currently aiming for my website and also some web development projects. So if you need the website, just contact me. I'll put in my WhatsApp number and my contact details and email address in the description. So this is it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. This is Keith Rainz. If you are new to this channel, make sure that you subscribe, like, and comment. Yeah. If you have any other questions, I reply and read to all comments on my YouTube channel, and I reply to them within an hour. So bye for now. So just a bonus before I go, let me just show you something which might be of help. I've got a Telegram group where I've got about 2,000 subscribers, and the Telegram chat group where I have like 1,000 plus. Okay, my Telegram channel has got Forex related people. Okay, almost everyone in my Telegram channel is a Forex trader. So in case you need help in Forex trading, there are people who are there ready to help you. Okay, so it's not really that I've abandoned Forex trading. Okay, so Forex trading, I think, is a thing I'll start doing in my free time, not something to make money and rely on it. So I'm going to consider Forex trading just as a fun thing to do, like just make money, and not something to do like as an everyday job. No. Okay, so I've not completely forgotten about Forex. Maybe when I start making more money, that's when maybe I'll start. That's when I'll go back to Forex trading, because the posting to my $10, $20, it's not really helping. Unless if I can be able like deposit like a $500, $1,000, so yeah, this year profits are very guaranteed. So this is it. This is what I had today. I've gone very far. This video has gone to almost 14 minutes. So I'll end this video right now. Bye for now.